The NBA Finals just happened yesterday, but it's already time to move on. There's no use regretting what happened. Send the move on and talk about the offseason, which is already going on. The NBA draft just 8 days away. Let's talk about the Phoenix Suns 2021 offseason. And it starts off with Chris Paul. We really need to re-sign Chris Paul. Because really, if you re-sign Chris Paul with this roster intact, you've got the number one team in the Western Conference. Let's be real. They're still the best team. And, you know, it's going to be a big deal to re-sign Chris Paul. But for this offseason, the Suns, they also got to manage DeAndre and Mikal Bridges. You want to re-sign both of those guys to extensions. You got Cameron Payne you have to re-sign. And a bunch of other stuff. Today is just going to be like an overview of the Suns offseason. And yeah, I'm going to have individual videos taking a look at their draft, taking a look at the free agency situation, but today, just talking about an overview. For the Suns, they have two different routes they can go down, pretty much. One is re-signing Chris Paul and just hoping it works out and having faith in the players. This seems like the most likely route for the Suns. I mean, first of all, you have Chris Paul. He has to decide if he wants to save the Suns. It seems more than likely, based on his words and his actions, that he's going to save the Suns. But there's rumors flying around everywhere saying he might want to go to the Lakers, he might want to go to the Pelicans. I mean, obviously they're not true. He hasn't made any statements in the 24 hours, less than 24 hours since the NBA Finals ended. And I don't think he's definitely not intending to move on right now. But Chris Paul seems like he wants a return. He's really built something here. And, you know, it's the thing he's built. It's going to be paying off fruits. And, you know, it's going to be DeAndre Ayton, Mikal Bridges, and Cameron Johnson taking a step up. Because Chris Paul, he's going to be 37 years old. It's going to be harder than ever to bet on him being healthy. But if these other guys take a step up, which they can, we've seen flashes of how good those three guys can be. If they become more consistent and the Suns can rely on them more. You know, the Suns have done, you know, they've really got something great building here. I think DeAndre Ayton figures it out more as a playmaker and as a passer and as a finisher. If he's a bit more proactive at attacking when he's at the top of the key and he does that thing where he just puts the ball on the floor, finishes it with a layup, that's super cool. We want more of that. We want Mikal Bridges creating in the mid-range, just finishing layups. He can do that. We've seen flashes of that. We've seen Cameron Johnson. He can do more than just hit the three. He can put the ball on the floor. He can hit the mid-range. He can finish. He can dunk on anyone. And we need more of that. We need more of that consistently. And we need the Suns to set up more of that and more. And just have faith in the players. Keep doing what you're doing. And that's just one option the Suns can do this offseason. The other option is, well, let's gamble and try to improve and just realize that maybe we could try to be better and we can try to improve. You know, there's a guy named Damian Lillard who's gonna request a trade in the next month or so. Do you take a look at him and you don't re-sign Chris Paul and then you look to trade like Mikal Bridges and Cameron Johnson, a bunch of other stuff, to trade for Damian Lillard? That's another option. I don't love that option. But you are getting a younger player and a guy who's more clutch and who is going to be, he's going to be very consistent and you're improving. Let's be real. Damian Lillard is a fantastic NBA player. The Suns would be very blessed if they had him on their roster. But that's just an option. And I don't think the Suns will go that way because they've had faith in their players up until this point. But it is something that can happen. And it does kind of feel like the DeAndre Ayton trade. Like if you do this, like, you'll probably regret it at the end of the day, and you just might as well hold put with the pieces you have right now and improve on this and get better. So what do the Suns do? You got to re-sign Chris Paul. I'm hoping he only wants from $20 to $25 million, and I think that's what he's worth at this point. You just can't rely on him being healthy. He's proven he's a winner, and he proves that he deserves a lot of money still. Like, he hasn't dropped off the face of the earth, but I don't think he's worth $44 million. There's a reason he declined that player option. And I'd really think he's going to be flexible with this team and flexible with the cap. It kind of feels like a reality television show where they're trying to lead off of the cliffhanger. Like, oh, he could potentially leave or he could potentially not. He's probably going to stay and he's probably going to take a pay cut because he's going to do what's best for the team. You know, it's just that gut feeling you have to have. that he's going to stick around, he's going to take a pay cut, and that's going to let the Suns re-sign other players to let them succeed. And I'm hoping Chris Paul is good with a two-year contract to leave things open to paying Cameron Johnson and paying Jalen Smith when those contracts end. And also, he's going to be 38 years old that second year. So, yeah, I'm hoping, you know, paying him until he's 39, he could still be good. Don't know at this point. Anyways, let's move on. I think it's a similar story in terms of that money for Aiden and Bridges. I mean, they're going to want more than 2 years. They're going to want that 4 year, maybe even 5 year. Can we pay them 5 years? I don't know. Probably 4 year deals. I don't think they're getting max contracts. I just think they weren't consistent enough during the regular season, and they had some great moments in the playoffs, but they also weren't consistent enough during the playoffs. They were great players, and I'm just not sure. I mean, it's best for the team. It's best for Robert Sarver, who probably doesn't want to go into the tax, which can be an issue during next season. If you have Chris Paul, DeAndre Ayton, Mikal Bridges, and Devin Booker, and everyone else under contract, that can be an issue. But yeah, I think they're going to be somewhere between $20 to $25 million. I don't know where it is yet, but you're paying those guys. You want them back, but you got to negotiate. You don't want to instantly give them the max contract. You want to save as much money as possible. But it isn't the end of the world for the Suns. The Suns still have money. They actually have three exceptions for signing players in free agency. One of those exceptions is probably going to be taken up by Cameron Payne. He does have early bird rights, but what that's worth is $3.2 million, and I don't think Cameron Payne's taking $3.2 mil. We do have our non-taxpayers mid-level exception, which is $9.5 million, and I think that's enough to sign Cameron Payne. He just wasn't consistent enough during the regular season, and once again, he had some great moments during the playoffs, had some really great games, but I don't think he's getting into that, you know, double-digit range of millions of dollars. I just don't think he's done enough, especially with his history up until this point. And also, once again, he has to be team-friendly. I mean, maybe he would want to move on and get paid somewhere else, but I think he's loyal. He's going to stick around and stick with his team. Cameron Payne is going to fill the mid-level exception. We also have two other exceptions. We have the biannual exception, which we decided to not use last year. And we're going to have a disabled player exception, which is going to be for Dario Saric. Dario Saric is going to be likely out for the entire season with his torn ACL, so the Suns will file for a disabled player exception that's worth half of his contract, which is around $4.3 million. That's a nice exception to have going into a free agency in which you want to stack this roster with talent. And, I mean, I guess just before I talk about the draft and talk about free agency, let's just talk about what's on the roster. When the Suns re-sign Chris Paul and Cameron Payne, they're up to, I believe, 10 players, which is Chris Paul, DeAndre Ayton, Devin Booker, Jay Crowder, Dario Saric, Mikal Bridges, Jalen Smith, Cameron Johnson, Javon Carter, and Cameron Payne. They're still, I'm pretty sure they're pretty decently far under the tax, and they can still afford to pay those exceptions without paying the tax. I don't know how willing Robert Sarver is going to be to paying the tax, but I think he'll be more willing to, especially after how successful the season has been, and he wrote us a thank you note after the season, so us the fans. So I'm hoping he does be willing to pay the tax, and yeah. The Suns will have 10 players on the roster. When you add the draft pick, you're up to 11. So they'll have quite a few slots to fill on their roster still. Let's start it off with Torrey Craig. That's an easy guy to try to re-sign. I don't think he's really earned much more than the veteran minimum. He also had some great minutes in the playoffs, and I think he did a fantastic job. He might even negotiate his way into like a biannual exception contract. I'm just not sure, you know? I would try to do our best to re-sign him for the minimum. He did a really great job against the Clippers. That's what really stood out to me. And adding him back into the rotation would be really great. I guess let's just talk about the Suns' rotation in general. Like, where do they even need to improve? You have Chris Paul and Cameron Payne. You have Jalen Smith. You gotta hope he steps up. I know I just skipped over to the power forward position. But you have Jalen Smith. You really have three power forwards on this roster, for being honest. Jay Crowder, Cameron Johnson, and Jalen Smith. And, yeah, I gotta hope Jalen Smith steps up this year. Doesn't wait around. And I think you just slide Cameron Johnson to the three. Then you just kind of have, you know, you've got 10 guys right there. You got Chris Paul, Cameron Payne as your point guards. You got Devin Booker and Javon Carter, your two guards. And you've got your small forward positions occupied by Mikal Bridges and Cameron Johnson, the power forwards, Jalen Smith and Jay Crowder. The center, you only have Aiden. I now realizing I counted Sarge. So you only have 9 players. You want to improve the guard, you know? Javon Carter, I want to improve there, and I want to improve at center, and I'm going to attack that through the draft. I'm also going to want to add some more wings onto this team. Adding Torrey Craig would be a great move, especially if you're signing him for the minimum, and I think the Suns would do their best to do that. You'd be up to 10 players. From there, I want the Suns to trade up in the draft and probably flip Javon Carter along with some second round picks and pick 29 to get up to pick 15 through to 21. I'm specifically looking at pick 15 from the Wizards, pick 17 from the Grizzlies, pick 19, or pick 21 from the Knicks. I think all 4 of those picks are going to be available for trade. I think the Suns need to be willing to move up to improve their roster with a cheaper contract. Specifically looking at Davion Mitchell and Trey Mann, if those two dudes drop, you're picking up a potential franchise point guard to fill in when Chris Paul does eventually leave or retire. And yeah, I'd be super down to draft one of those guys. But otherwise, trading up in this draft, it really puts you in the sweet spot. 29 is not a good place to be in this draft. I also want the Suns to acquire a second round pick between 35 and 45. I think that's another sweet spot to add another wing. And you can just trade future seconds and some money to make that happen. If we add those two players and subtract Javon Carter, and we are also added Torrey Craig, we're up to 12 players on the roster. Actually, 11 players on the roster. My bad. 11 players on the roster. That's when we get into free agency. Looking at the players that the Suns are losing that I haven't already talked about. Each one more. Langston Galloway, Frank Kaminsky, Abdul Nader, and Tyshawn Alexander. Out of those guys, I like Frank Kaminsky the most, especially since he came into Game 6 and actually played big minutes. He's also a very good regular season player. I think if you need minutes out of him, you're going to get something solid, and I'm fine with Frank Kaminsky. I think he's a great locker room guy. I think he's a great personality. I think this is probably the last guy you sign. If you're signing your 15th slot, I think he's the last guy you sign. But Frank Kaminsky, out of those guys, I liked him the most. I also like Langston Galloway just jumping in, hitting some threes, also a solid defender, especially if we're trading away Javon Carter. I think there's a use for having Langston Galloway around. And Abdul Nader, Suns kind of liked him. They even played him against the Clippers after he's out for 3 months. That is a big question mark for me, and I don't know what the Suns plan to do. All those guys should be available for the minimum, and we shouldn't have to use either biannual exception or the disabled player exception on them. Then just taking a quick look at the free agents that the Suns could sign for those exceptions, mainly looking point guard and center. I'm looking at Patty Mills, TJ McConnell, Raul Nader really impressed me off that Wizards team. You also look in center with Nerlens Noel, Richaun Holmes, JaVale McGee, and Dwight Howard. Those are kind of the guys you're looking at. Yeah, maybe some forwards I would throw in there as well. Danny Green, Tony Snell, Josh Hart, Nick Batum, Trevor Ariza, Paul Millsap, Carmelo Anthony. All those guys should be available for those exceptions. And Suns really need to be proactive, adding more talent to this team, adding more players who can play and get it done, and just raise the standard of the talent of this team. You know, all these guys can contribute, all these guys can be effective, and the Suns need to look to pick these guys up, if you ask me. Anyways, I think that about covers it. I'm going to have individual videos on free agency on the draft, and stay posted for those. But anyways, that's it. Thanks for watching. If you made it to the end, please consider hitting subscribe, because you probably want to see more of my content. And I will see you in the next one. Goodbye.